Natchez Tujasis has been dealing in charcoal for years. Until recently, her cargo would get to the capital city without any trouble. But since the president banned tree cutting for commercial charcoal production, the dynamics have changed. Now she has to maneuver like other charcoal dealers in a profitable yet destructive business. Natchez Tujasis testifies bending rules to release a truck loaded with 370 bags of charcoal from Amuru police post. Sometimes you may find a police officer on the way, and you explain to them, promising that you will never return back. You then give them a bribe and they let you go. But they emphasize that when they let you go, you never return because the president issued a directive banning people from trading in charcoal. Yet here in Bulenga, Kampala, where she operates, customers buy a basin of charcoal at 10,000 shillings with little or no regard to the impacts it's making on the environment. It's a dilemma for the dealers who have only known charcoal dealing as a source of livelihood, and Natchez acquired a loan for her business. I got a loan from Centenary Bank to begin this business and haven't paid it back. And a month, I'm expected to pay 1,100,000 shillings. How do they expect us to pay these loans? Those who have suffered from the impact of climate change in northern Uganda, the epicenter of charcoal burning in the country, pushed hard for the ban. The executive order, exercised under Article 99, Clause 2 of the Constitution, was issued by the president in May 2023. The president, however, faulted corrupt elements in security forces, National Environment Management, and National Forest Authority for aiding the charcoal business.
They bring the key. Where is it? Bring the key.
Twesje Emmanuel is a well-known commercial charcoal dealer in the Amuru district. He explains how they accumulate and transport heaps of charcoal despite the directive. Commercial charcoal business was a revenue base for Gulu district, 70% of revenue collected from forest products. As of last financial year in the first quarter, the district was able to only raise 50 million shillings out of the estimated 900 million shillings. The council is finding alternative sources of revenue.
We are thinking of seeing an alternative. And for us as the council, we are seeing that we could actually invest more revenue on this milk business by December. Lalo.
I'm so happy upon hearing that our efforts towards environmental injustice are indicating positive response. Most of the time we've been saying that districts are benefiting from commercial charcoal business. The drop in the revenue collection is an indicator that our effort towards environmental injustice has borne fruits. It's a long journey to a total shift to an alternative source of energy, but until then, the fight against charcoal production continues.
And since the issue of environment has been also captured by the executive order, it is high time you saw the source.
Odong Stefan Latek is the district resident commissioner. He's warning defiant commercial charcoal dealers of intense operations to implement the ban.
We arrest, get a court order auction. Arrest, get a court order auction. It is not important for us to arrest charcoal already. We need to protect the trees before they are cut. And so we are moving into the forest.
Figures show that Gulu district alone lost a total of 38,700 hectares of forest cover between 2010 and 2021, accounting for about 6.2% loss of forest cover nationwide. According to a Global Forest Watch report, the bulk of forest cover was depleted due to the growing charcoal trade and wild forest fires. Report compiled by Danish OT for the news.